Mediums are excellent for thinning down your paints. Larmin Medium is a shade without pigment, so it's ideal for thinning down your shade paints, especially if you want a lighter tone or just gradually build that colour up. And Contrast Medium is a contrast paint without pigment as well. And again, this is ideal for thinning down those colours, but it's really useful on large surface areas like cloaks or even power armour if you want to avoid any blotches on those surface areas. So first of all, we're going to use Larmin Medium. Now I'm going to be using a medium shade brush for this, and one of the things I like to do is I always apply the Larmin Medium first because I don't want to contaminate the pot. So all I'm going to do is add a couple of paintbrushes of Larmin Medium to my palette, and then I'm going to add one paintbrush of my shade. For this, I'm going to be using Seraphim Sepia. I'm just going to mix the two together like so, and all I'm going to do is grab the model, and I'll be using a Termagant for this. So this is going to give it that kind of skin tone of High Fleet Kraken, and all I'm going to do is start applying that all over the skin. And you can see it's just slowly changing the tone of that undercoat to be more of a beige colour and just run into those recesses. And there we are with that medium and shade mix now dry. You can see it subtly changed the actual undercoat to be more of a beige tone and yet ran into those recesses to give it some nice definition. So what I'm going to do now is we're going to move on to using the contrast medium. We're going to do pretty much the same thing. So I'm going to start by using my medium shade brush and apply a couple of dollops or paintbrushes worth of contrast medium to my palette. And then one paintbrush of Ultra Greens Blue. And I'm just going to mix that in together like so. And again, it's a little bit thinner than using it straight from the pot. And all I'm going to do now is start applying that to this Intercessor Marine. And again, I'm just going to start applying it all over the model. Make sure you really, really pull it on and run into those recesses as well. And there we are with that medium mix now applied and dry. You can see it's helped reduce some of that blotchiness on those armor panels. And again, you can always apply multiple coats of this to build up that color. Now, there's a couple of things to remember when using mediums. I'd always apply the medium onto the palette first before using other colours. This will just avoid contaminating your pots. And secondly, I'd always recommend using a slightly larger brush for the task, depending on the model that you're doing. If you use too much of a smaller brush, you'll start to get some streaky effects. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this, and I hope you enjoy using Larmin Medium and Contrast Medium yourselves, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.